Many divers underestimate the significance of cylinder selection, often settling for the wrong rental options or making uninformed purchasing decisions that can compromise their diving experience. However, choosing the right cylinder type is crucial, as it directly impacts the safety and efficiency of your dive. The reality is that divers are often unaware of the real differences between aluminum and steel cylinders, which can lead to them using equipment that's not tailored to their specific needs. To ensure a safe and enjoyable dive, let's take a closer look at the key characteristics, benefits, and drawbacks of both aluminum and steel cylinders, so you can make informed decisions about which one is best for your diving style and conditions. Known for their durability and strength, steel tanks use less raw material than aluminium, but they tend to be always negatively buoyant, which means they sink whether full or empty. The wall thickness of a steel cylinder typically ranges between 4.2 and 5 millimeters. Working pressures vary from 230 to 300 bar, with high-pressure cylinders constructed with greater thickness to enhance strength. The finish of a steel cylinder typically includes at least a zinc coating to prevent rapid rusting when exposed to water, and they may also be painted. Steel can rust quickly due to its iron content, which can lead to a significant loss of metal mass over time, compromising the cylinder's integrity and necessitating regular maintenance to prevent further corrosion. Due to aluminum's softer nature, these tanks require thicker walls to handle pressurized gas, so their thickness usually ranges between 11.8 and 15.5 millimeters. Aluminium tanks are slightly negatively buoyant at the start of a dive and shift to positive buoyancy as they empty. Their typical working pressures range from 200 to 230 bar. The finish of an aluminium cylinder might be uncoated, painted, or galvanized. Uncoated aluminum cylinders facilitate early detection of corrosion, allowing for immediate inspection and maintenance. Aluminum does not rust, instead it undergoes a natural oxidation process that forms a protective layer on its surface. This layer usually appears as a mild discoloration but remains superficial, effectively shielding the metal from further corrosion. Steel cylinders, primarily manufactured using the deep draw method, are mostly crafted from high-quality chrome molybdenum steel, which is drawn into the form by a machined punch. Deep drawing is a sheet metal forming process in which a flat blank is held in place by a blank holder, also known as force, while the central portion of the sheet is pushed into a die opening using a punch. This draws the metal into the desired shape without causing wrinkles or splits in the form part. Aluminum cylinders are crafted through a process called backward extrusion, where a metal rod is forced into a lump of aluminum alloy and cylindrical mold. In backward extrusion, aluminum slugs are shaped into scuba cylinders by subjecting them to roughly 2,500 tons of pressure through an extrusion press. This immense force creates frictional heat, elevating the aluminum's temperature to around 150 degrees Celsius. The material's malleability allows it to extrude around the press piston, forming the cylinder's basic structure in only 20 seconds. The original markings engraved on the neck of a scuba cylinder typically include details such as the manufacturer's name, the month and year of production, which also indicates the original hydro test, the serial number, the mark of an independent DOT inspector, or CE certification number, the service pressure and maximum working pressure, the volume and the weight of the cylinder when empty. The arrangement and specific details may vary by manufacturer. Therefore, it is advisable to consult online manuals or contact the manufacturer directly if you're uncertain about the information on the cylinder. These markings are particularly important when purchasing a new cylinder. However, if you're considering a secondhand unit or using a rental cylinder, ensure it has the latest hydro test date stamped on the neck and displays a label indicating the most recent visual inspection. This label should indicate the dates of the last inspection, the due dates for the next required inspection, the cylinder's serial number, and the inspector's details. Typically found on the side of the cylinder, these labels vary by inspection provider, but generally consist of a table of years and months with punctured holes marking the relevant inspection dates. Each cylinder must undergo annual visual inspections and hydrostatic tests every 5 years. The visual inspection includes a detailed examination of both the exterior and interior of the cylinder, searching for damage such as cuts, dents, corrosion, coating imperfections, and thread integrity. A hydrostatic test is a little more complex, as it evaluates a cylinder's structural integrity under pressure. In this procedure, the cylinder is first filled with water and placed within a sealed water-filled chamber known as a water jacket. It is then pressurized to a specific test pressure, typically 5/3 of its standard working pressure. As the cylinder expands, it displaces water from the jacket. By precisely measuring the volume of displaced water, inspectors can determine the extent of the cylinder's expansion, verifying whether it can safely withstand its rated pressures over time. Ultimately, the choice of cylinder type is a matter of personal preference. However, there are specific scenarios in which aluminum cylinders are essential, such as when carrying decompression or stage cylinders. While steel tanks might require adding less weight, they tend to hang low and remain negatively buoyant even when empty. This positioning can significantly impact streamlining. Additionally, dropping a steel cylinder could result in losing it and becoming underweighted, potentially causing buoyancy issues. Aluminum cylinders are typically neutral to slightly positive in buoyancy, which enhances travel and maneuverability, especially when scootering, and they float when released, preventing them from becoming lodged in silty environments or lost in deep water. Additionally, during longer dives, empty aluminum cylinders, unlike those made of steel, can be sent up on a line as they float when unclipped. These characteristics make aluminum the preferred option for stage and deco bottles. Thanks for watching and hope you learned something. Consider subscribing to Flow State Divers to become part of the community of conscious divers and to get notified on our upcoming content.